Time for some fun with the audio soundbites here, my friends. We'll start with me, in fact. I just want you to hear, just to be reminded, this was me back on June 17th of last year. Last year sounds like a long time ago, but it wasn't really, just 6 months ago.
There isn't a Democrat versus Republican mindset in Washington anymore, ladies and gentlemen. There is an election, presidential election. There's a pretense of it. But in truth, the only real enemy of Washington today is the Tea Party. The Republican and Democrat establishments, the Chamber of Commerce, the whole way Washington is working, the only enemy is people who want to reintroduce free markets, get rid of crony capitalism, blow up the relationships that exist between Washington and individual businesses or business at large, Wall Street firms. You people in the Tea Party, the liberty, freedom, free markets, you represent the problem. To John Boehner, to the Republican establishment, to the Republican consultants, Obama's not the problem. Anybody opposed to the way Washington does business today is the problem, and that would be you and me.
And that's from last June, and it's, I think, only intensified. It has to have intensified, but since then, we had this landslide, and you look at it two ways. Landslide election victory for the Republicans without a mandate. I mean, well, they didn't campaign on it. They have a mandate. It's called Stop Obama. They don't want it. They don't want to touch that. They don't want any part of stopping Obama. That's stopping Washington. And that's just, that's not the rule of day. The other aspect is a landslide loss for the Democrats. Huge. And the second midterm landslide defeat in a row for the Democrats. They've lost a lot of seats nationally and at the state level. They're ripe, sitting ducks, and they're not the enemy. They really aren't, as far as the Republican Party is concerned. Here's some evidence. Yesterday in Washington, at the Washington Center and Bipartisan Policy Center. Well, that's a great place, isn't it? Washington Bipartisan Policy Center. Former Senator Robert Bennett of Utah spoke, and he was talking about the Republican Party. And this is just a portion of what he said.
Just as the people under McGovern went too far in that direction, in the Tea Party thing, they have gone too far, slipped off the edge of the menu completely into Alice in Limbaugh land. And as a result, they've made themselves irrelevant to the governing process. And I've said to some of my Democratic friends, if we Republicans can't contain that, the Democrats are going to win 5 out of the next 6 presidential elections just the way the Republicans did.
Did you hear all that? Forget the Alice in Limbaugh land bit, which is what makes the soundbite fun and is one of the reasons why I played it. But you hear this guy's out talking to Democrats about you. Complaining about you to the Democrats. You think a Democrat's ever gone to Robert Bennett and started complaining about Bill Maher? Or John Stewart? Oh, man, we got to, you know, if we don't get rid of these guys that are making us look like nuts and communists here, we're never going to win the presidency. You ever hear the Democrats talking to Republicans? Here's Robert Bennett. He's proud. Former Senator Utah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, this Tea Party thing, they've gone too far. They slipped off the edge of the menu completely into Alice in Limbaugh. The Tea Party is the heart, the backbone of this country. The Tea Party is the people who make this country work. The Tea Party is the natural Republican base. But that's not how they see it. You know how they see the Tea Party? You know, when you say Tea Party, what do you think they see? Well, it's a tie, but they probably see Christine O'Donnell and Sarah Palin and maybe Sharon Angle or who knows whoever. But that's who they see. And they think that everybody in the Tea Party is, I mean, there is, when you compare the two bases, and I consider the Tea Party to be the Republican base, when you, the Republican base and the Democrat base, and you think it's the Tea Party that's off the edge of sanity, what in the world else must you think? That to me is just a striking soundbite. These guys probably agree with de Blasio that the cops are the problem in New York City. It really is amazing, but I wanted you to hear it. And I kind of like this Alice in Limbaugh land. They obviously think of me when they think of the Tea Party. And frankly, other than supporting it, I've got nothing to do with the Tea Party. And neither does anybody else, really. The Tea Party came into existence out of thin air, essentially. And what I mean by that is the Tea Party doesn't have a leader. The Tea Party just came into existence because of the shock and awe at what was happening to America by Obama. Average Americans who had never been in politics before, and that's the rub. They've never been in politics before, and they can't be controlled. They can't be buttoned up, and they can't be set aside. They can't be utilized as normal political groups are. Because they don't really know who they are. You're never going to be able to get rid of the Tea Party. This is the thing that Republicans don't understand. You're never going to be able to get rid of the Tea Party because the Tea Party is made up of average Americans who happen to be the ones still making this country work. There's no way to get rid of them. They live and breathe. And they happen to be people who just came into existence because they were outraged at what they saw happening to their government, their country, and they wanted it stopped. And don't you love it? All these people talking about how the Tea Party, yeah, it's faded away. Yeah, the Tea Party, not a problem anymore. Tea Party, it's had its day. It shot its wad. Tea Party exists anymore. And then every election, people become shocked and dismayed that the Tea Party's still there and still a factor. And they start ripping into it again, just as former Senator Bennett did here. Eric Cantor, who was defeated. Remember, he was in line to be Speaker. Second in command of Republican leadership. He went down to defeat in Virginia. And so now he's working on Wall Street somewhere at a financial institution. Anyway, he was on CNBC, which has lost all of its audience. Did you know that? CNBC and CNN are competing for the number of people you can put in a thimble. And it's amazing what has happened to CNBC. It's MSNBC ditto. Anyway, Cantor showed up over there last night, actually this morning, on their program Squawk Box. And the co-host with Joe Kernan, he said to Eric Cantor, is the president going to be willing to alienate the far left with some of these things like tax reform or trade? I can comment on that question, but I'm not going because I want to get to the end. Here's what Cantor said.
This is the question. The question is, will the next 2 years be spent relitigating the differences that have been well-defined over the last 6 years, right? I mean, we know that Republicans don't agree with Obama right. on environmental reform or his health care bill or his unilateral moves on immigration. We also know that Democrats don't agree with Republicans on tax reform, entitlement reform, and the rest. So are we going to be spending the next 2 years and see Congress relitigating that, or are we going to get something done?
Here we go again. Here we go with this magic, are we going to get something done? Is just getting something done all there is? What if the something that gets done adds up to being more and more destruction? And if it's what Obama wants, that's what it's going to be. What is wrong with relitigating or to continue to litigate? What was this election? The election was about stopping any more of this. It couldn't be any more clear. And yet here's another former, capital F, another former Republican advising us on how we need to be here. We need to stop talking about the last 6 years. We need to start working together and getting something done. What does Cantor want to get done? Does he want amnesty? What does he want? Does he want Obamacare fully implemented so it's no longer an issue? I mean, that's been the Republican modus operandi. Just agree with the Democrats whatever they want every 90 days and then tell us, don't worry, don't worry, don't worry. We had to give them this. Get this issue off the table. We're losing this issue. But we'll kick their butt the next time. And it just keeps playing itself out like Groundhog Day. So what do they want to get done? Amnesty? What do they want to get done? fully implement paid-for Obamacare? What do they want to get done? Got to take a timeout, folks. Sit tight. Back with much more after this.